Hi everyone, welcome to the CSI studio. I'm Mark Dorsey, CSI's Chief Executive Officer, and I'm here today with Marvin Kemp. I think you said from the stage, right, we've been very good about inviting people that are like us, but the next challenge is doing that with people who aren't like us.
That's correct, and it's a big challenge. Mm-hmm. You know, I look around, it's similar to the example that Kurt Moody gave from the stage, you know, of the bank. Their diversity numbers look very good, but when you drill down into it, it was only at that lower level.
Right.
The executives and the management, you know, that E-suite was still the same.
Right.
And it, you know, I think it's that way in a lot of firms.
Mm-hmm.
Kurt quoted a statistic, you know, less than 5% of registered architects are minorities.
Mm-hmm.
And that's true. And it's been true for decades.
Mm-hmm.
But what I'm seeing, and I think what most of the U.S. is seeing in our schools of architecture is we are getting more diverse.
Mm-hmm.
So those barriers to entering our profession are starting to crumble a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Not as much as we need them to.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you look at it, a traditional education is 4 years.
Yep.
Architecture, it's either 5 or 6.
Mm-hmm.
That's a very real financial barrier.
Sure.
And so we need to do what we can to break those down. But when we go, when my firm goes into job fairs at colleges and universities, we're seeing a lot of young women, we're seeing a lot of people of color, and that's great. That makes our firms better. That elevates our profession because we are all not from the suburbs, not from upper middle class. We have different experiences,
yep,
different cultures, and that's great. Now we need to overcome the barrier of how do we get those people licensed and then bring them into CSI. And you know, Lakeisha Woods gave an example from the stage of recruiting construction trades.
Mm-hmm.
And how do we do that? And so I think, you know, we need to go out into our building partners and seek out what are they doing to increase the diversity of their workforces, because
mm-hmm,
they're having the same conversations we are as design professionals.
There's no shortage of women in STEM, mm-hmm, given the emphasis over the last decade,
right.
But the issue is, are underrepresented populations being invited to the party to begin with, and not just at that lower level, but in leadership.
Correct.
And that's the real challenge. Is it's one thing to say congratulations, you're in the firm, but are you going to be at the leadership table?
That's correct.
And how does that table change?
It's tough.
Yep.
It's really tough because people, at least in the design professions, you know, you stay at a firm 2 or 3, maybe 5 years, and then you move to the next one.
Mm-hmm.
In our firm, when you've been with us about 5 years, we're starting to think about, is this person leadership material? Are they someone that we want to invite to be an associate, to move up to be a senior associate and a principal?
Right.
And when young people have joined us and then they leave after 5 years, we find it very difficult to then backfill with someone of equal experience. And we haven't conquered that challenge yet at the office, but we're working on it every single day.
That mobility you talk about is a real challenge because people, you know, we're in the great resignation right now, right?
Yeah.
People are finding other opportunities. They're really evaluating what their work experience is going to be.
Absolutely.
So even then, it's not just about the work experience. Marvin, thank you for spending a little bit of time this morning.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us in the CSI studio. I'm Mark Dorsey, CSI Chief Executive Officer. Thanks for being with us.
Mm-hmm.